Hi, I'm Matt DeGreeff, Dean of College Counseling and Student Enrichment at Middlesex School in Concord, Massachusetts. And it's my pleasure today to talk to you about thoughts on the summer of 2021. Many of your parents may use the expression ROI, return on investment. I want to flip that around and talk about return on intention. How do you want to bring purpose, aim, and determination to act to your summer? The summer of 2021 that will probably be as unusual as it was for the summer of 2020. I know we're all hopeful that things will be turning around, but this summer will still be very unusual under any other circumstances. Reframing your summer for ROI. Think about your summer in terms of a few different factors. Do you want credentialing experiences? Are you looking for grades, recommendations, feathers in the cap, things you can add to your resume? Are you looking for exposure and opportunities to learn about your career opportunities down the road, what you might want to major in college, and things you might want to explore? So think about your summer in terms of credentials versus exposure. And in many cases, getting exposure to things that you may want to pursue later on in life will be more important. You want to make sure that you're authentically connecting whatever you do this summer to your interests, your passions, and your future. And do not be afraid to get out of your comfort zone. You may want to try to do something, even if it's just for a week, that's something you may not be able to do during the school year, and it may be something that you want to explore, but really haven't given yourself the chance to do it. So think about getting out of your comfort zone. There is tremendous value in getting a summer job, and I can't tell you how many of my students I've worked with over the years have found great meaning, understanding of the dignity of work, and learning how to deal with adults, dealing with money and all the other things that can happen through a summer job. And keep in mind that most of the people who will be reading your college applications are folks who did summer work, who went to college on financial aid and believe in the nobility of work. And there's another theory out there called the grit test, and having a job is something the colleges look for because it's an element of grit and determination that they really admire in the college process. And there's real value in downtime over the summer too. Read more, screen less. And I think after another year of a lot of Zoom classes, we all need less screen. And I would really recommend going around to your favorite teachers or favorite adults in your life and asking them for one of their top books, their favorite book. Create your own reading list and think about reading some books that will connect you to people in your life. And you may learn something about them. You may learn something about yourself. And again, it could be a real opportunity thinking about how you want to articulate who you are as a person. Reading is always a win-win. And the last thing you might want to think about is the possibility of engaging online, which is kind of counterintuitive to what I just said. But there are a lot of amazing online opportunities to find connection with people who are pursuing the same interests as you. I've had several students over the past summer who found art communities, theater communities, photography, political activism, lots of opportunity to connect with other young people who are pursuing the same passion. So look around on the different platforms and see if you can find those communities, and you may find that you're going to be able to connect with kids who you want to stay in touch with for the rest of your life. It's really amazing the kind of tools that your generation has in terms of social media. Reflecting on your summer. Now, this is super important as you move forward. I think it's something you want to consider as you have that first summer job or pursue things that are outside your comfort zone. Keep a diary. I say to my students, write an email to yourself, create a little something in your phone, or even an old-fashioned paper diary, and jot down your notes, your ideas, impressions, moments. And before you know it, you're going to find yourself collecting a lot of terrific ideas for essays. I had one student who worked at a fast food restaurant, and he was working the drive-through window, and he realized that he had to deliver the food within 64 seconds. The whole model, the whole business model was around efficiency and not around humanity. And he really was able to understand how this particular fast food chain treated its employees and treated the customers. And it was a really powerful moment for him when he kind of came to that realization. I've also had students who worked on farms and got really into the business model of farms and dug into the ideas and backgrounds of the farmers who worked there full time and wrote some really powerful essays in terms of wanting to go on to business school after learning how farming works in our local community. So there's lots of different ways that you can write down and collect your thoughts. The My Coalition app platform has a tremendous amount of range in terms of uploading videos that you can do video diaries, or you can upload your journal notes into your locker in the Coalition app. And that's something to think about as you plan for the college application process. And you want to think about, how does your summer opportunities tie to your personal narrative? Because these elements could work their way into a really good and thoughtful college essay. So summer opportunities in the summer. The realities of the new environment. Admissions offices know that under COVID-19, a lot of summer opportunities are limited. And there's no doubt about that. The colleges are very understanding. So you need to think about ways that you're contributing to your family, your community, to your environment. So if you're caring and attending to family members, you're babysitting and taking care of younger siblings or cousins or other kids in the neighborhood, that's really valuable. And that's something that the colleges value as well, and something you can articulate in your college application. Most summer programs at college, on college campuses, are going to be remote, and they are expensive. So if you're not able to do those programs, you're not at a disadvantage. It's something that everyone's dealing with right now. And the programs, due to their costs, even online, can make it prohibitive for a lot of kids to do them. And the colleges totally understand that. There are a lot of opportunities to do research online. And so if you are interested in a particular field, or if you want to learn more about a particular intellectual path, reach out to college professors on college campuses and see if there's some way that you can participate virtually. And that might be a way to make some connections with a college. In-person internships are probably not going to be available, and they're usually hard to find for teenagers. Most employers are looking for college students and people with more skills and credentials who can bring those elements to the summer internship program. But maybe you can talk to folks in your community, talk to your parents, talk to your parents' friends, and find out if you can shadow somebody for a day, even if it's virtually, and learn about their work, their life, and how they got to where they are. And you'll be surprised at their journey. And I think that's something that can really inform your path as you move forward. And travel opportunities are going to be really limited this summer in terms of going overseas and traveling even around the country. So I think you need to give yourself space to think about what's available around you within your environment and ways that you can get connected. There are lots of opportunities, lots of things that you can do. There are a lot of free opportunities on things like Khan Academy and Schoolhouse World if you want to just improve your academic skills, move forward in the curriculum, and maybe even become a tutor online. There's a lot of opportunity to volunteer right now in our communities. And if you really want to get involved with the vaccination process, helping out with COVID testing, delivering food, helping the elders in your community by cutting their grass, there are a lot of ways to get involved in small ways and big ways. So do not underestimate the opportunity just to help your fellow person in your community. We are finding that more athletic camps, tournaments, and showcases for kids who are really wanting to pursue athletics are opening up. So that might be an opportunity for you to explore, but just be careful. We talked about summer job opportunities that are going to be limited and localized. So you're going to have to probably look hard for those job opportunities. But a lot of employers are looking for teenagers to fill slots in a lot of the basic retail and fast food industry. Summer camps may be opening up in your area. So if you want to think about being a counselor in training or even a camp counselor, working with children and developing those skills are super valuable and something that college admissions officers value as well. And you can always do a lot of college tours and information sessions. If you just go to a college's visit page, you will be able to find opportunities to engage with them online. It may be really hard to visit a college campus in person. If you're able to walk around the campus safely, you know, you may want to try that. And more colleges are opening up around the country. But be smart, be careful, and really honor what the colleges want. If they don't want you to come to campus, do the virtual opportunities. I want to offer you a few summer resources. Two resources that we recommend to our students at Middlesex. One is teenlife.com. Teenlife.com has a tremendous amount of information, listings, and really in-depth information that you might be able to use to find summer opportunities. So dive into teenlife.com. And there's something on our Middlesex website that you're welcome to tap into. We have an extensive summer enrichment opportunity list, and the website is here listed on the page, and you're welcome to jump on and grab that if you want to. It does list a lot of very expensive programs, but it also lists programs if you're interested in mindfulness, debate camp, research. So there's some things there that you might find interesting. It's not the complete list of everything, but it's a list that our students have used and reflect many other programs that our students have used over the years. Thank you for taking the time to listen to this little presentation. I hope it helps, and I hope you have a safe and really engaged summer where you're really finding your intention, your purpose, and I hope that the college process goes well for you down the road. Take care and have a great day.